Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord.
A reading from the book of Jeremiah. At that time, says the Lord, I will be the God of all the families of Israel, and they shall be my people. Thus says the Lord, the people who survived the sword found grace in the wilderness. When Israel sought for rest, the Lord appeared to him from far away. I have loved you with an everlasting love. Therefore, I have continued my faithfulness to you. Again, I will build you, and you shall be built, O Virgin Israel. Again, you shall take your tambourines and go forth in the dance of the merrymakers. Again, you shall plant vineyards on the mountains of Samaria. The planters shall plant and shall enjoy the fruit. For there shall be a day when sentinels will call in the hill country of Ephraim. Come, let us go up to Zion, to the Lord our God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Jews and the other Gentiles. I truly understand that God shows no partiality, but in every nation, anyone who fears him and does what is right is acceptable to him. You know the message he sent to the people of Israel, preaching peace by Jesus Christ. He is Lord of all. That message spread throughout Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John announced, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power, how he went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses to all that he did, both in Judea and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree, but God raised him on the third day and allowed him to appear, not to all the people, but to us who were chosen by God as witnesses and who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one ordained by God as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Simon Peter came following him and went into the tomb. He saw the linen wrappings lying there and the cloth that had been on Jesus' head, not lying with the linen wrappings, but rolled up in a place by itself. Then the other disciple who reached the tomb first also went in, and he saw and believed. For as yet they did not understand the scripture that he must rise from the dead. And the disciples returned to their homes. But Mary stood weeping outside the tomb. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb, and she saw two angels in white sitting where the body of Jesus had been lying, one at the head and the other at the feet. They said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" And she said to them, "They have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him." When she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there. But she did not know that it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away." Jesus said to her, "Mary." And she turned to him and said in Hebrew, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Do not hold on to me, because I have not yet ascended to the Father. But go to my brothers and say to them, I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord." And she told them that he had said these things to her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
In the name of the loving, liberating, and life-giving God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Alleluia. Christ is risen. The Lord is risen indeed. These words seem to bring a different sense of being today. On any other Easter morning, these words would echo throughout our cathedral. We would be gathered, physically gathered together, sharing in the good news of the risen Christ. We would have had a glorious procession with organ, trumpets, and timpani drums filling our ears with triumphal music. We would inhale the scent of spring flowers and lilies adorning our nave. We would see children dressed in their Easter outfits, spring-colored dresses, and seasonal hats. Oh, the hats. We would see families gathered, pictures flashing as youngsters flowered the cross, and stomachs yearning for the anticipated Easter feast. But today we are separated, isolated, quarantined. Today, we are challenged by a pandemic that has literally consumed our world. Thousands of people are dying. Hundreds of thousands of people are sick. Our leaders are divided politically. Our economy has been devastated. People are living in anxiety and fear. Their hope is fading as they search for answers and pray for a miracle. Many of us may be wondering, where is the risen Christ? I, like many of you, have been watching as it seems our world is disintegrating around us. On this Easter morning, it would be easy for us to feel we are still in the darkness of Good Friday. Where is the new fire? The light of Christ in the world. This past week, I was driving through a residential area in the central part of our city. It was one of the first spring days we have all come to love. Blue skies, bright sun, that just warm enough, not too cool temperature, a gentle breeze reminding us of the air around us. One of those perfect days. As I drove down the street, a brightness caught my eye. I slowed to look more intently, and there in someone's front yard was a field of yellow tulips. The field was about the size of a tennis court, Rows and rows of yellow tulips gazing into the sunlight, gently swaying in the breeze. I was so taken by the brightness and beauty of the flowers, I went and got Debbie to show her. We drove back, stopped in front of the house, and just quietly sat there, enjoying the splendor and beauty of these flowers. When we returned home, we both sat back down to our computers to work. The house was quiet when I began to hear a sound from the outside. I turned to Debbie and said, "What is that?" She listened for a moment and said, "It's a dove." We both looked out our back window, and there sitting on the fence was a beautiful white dove. The dove was standing with her head held high, cooing into the air. A moment later, we noticed two cardinals had landed on the branch of a tree, and then several sparrows were dancing on the ground, hopping from place to place. I turned to Debbie and I said, "Maybe that's the Holy Spirit trying to tell us everything is going to be all right." It was in that moment I was reminded God is always with us. On this Easter morning, when we wonder where the risen Christ might be, we find him in those tulips. We find him in the dove and cardinal and sparrows. As we look out upon our world today, the risen Christ is all around us, in the families who, being forced to stay home, are taking walks together, in the employees of the grocery stores and supermarkets who are making sure we have food to eat, in the truckers who continue to carry goods across this country, in the postal worker who delivers our mail every morning, in the teachers who continue to teach from a distance, in our first responders who come to our aid regardless of the danger, in our nurses and doctors and technicians who every day, despite the risk, return to care for those who are sick and dying. For me, on this Easter morning, I am seeing the risen Christ in all of us, telling us the world doesn't have the final say, and Jesus will see us through. This Easter is my last as your bishop. I am saddened we could not be together physically, but I want to say thank you. Thank you for your support, your friendship, and your love over these last 13 years. Debbie and I have been blessed in ways we could never have imagined. Our prayer this day is that you will know the love and peace of the risen Christ in all your days. Alleluia. Christ is risen. The Lord is risen indeed.
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate of the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified on the cross of Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord.
giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken with the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us pray for the Church and the world. United in your truth, live together in your love, and reveal your glory in the world. Especially for Justin of Canterbury, Michael, our presiding bishop, Edward, our bishop, Holson, our bishop coadjutor, Daniel, bishop of Uruguay, and the clergy and the people of the Diocese of Oklahoma and our companion Diocese of Uruguay. Almighty God, giver of every good gift, live graciously on your church, and so guide the minds of those who shall choose the deed of this cathedral, that we may receive a faithful pastor who will care for your people and equip us for our ministries. Guide the people of this land and of all the nations in the way of justice and peace, that we may honor one another and serve the common good, especially for Donald, our president, Kevin, our governor, and David, our mayor. Give us all a reverence for the earth as your own creation, that we may use its resources rather in the service of others and to your honor and glory. Comfort and heal all those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit.
We pray for all in need of healing, especially Will Schneeberger, Ann Colley Fowler, Hugh Berriman, Kathy O'Connor, Mary Ellen Meredith, Wendy Kuser, Deacon Gary Williams, Gary Baer, Lee Eldridge, Leon Dement, Sam Pascal, Joanne Smith, Dolores Plowman, Tony Scott. For the needs of all who are impacted and afflicted by the coronavirus and all healthcare workers on the front lines, and for the special needs of those infected by the virus, Amy Masters, Dan Hart, Harrison Smith, Tiffany Self, Janine Bryant, Tim Sharp, Jane Sharp. Defend all who are serving our country, especially those in dangerous circumstances. For all who are celebrating birthdays and anniversaries, and for all who are traveling. Give rest and let light perpetual shine upon those who behold in memory this day, and for the recently departed. Carolyn von Steele-Gokenbach, Henry Blinderman and Gail Malmstrom, Tim Cott, Mary Totenkall, Sister Jan Futrell. And we pray that we may share with all your saints in the joy of your eternal kingdom.
Happy Easter to those of you at home. I hope that you are enjoying our Easter morning. This is a different Easter morning because we're not all right here together, but we are together, even though we are apart. I've been thinking about all of these scriptures in the last 3 days and about Jesus being placed in a tomb, and being inside of that tomb and how his disciples were upset by that. And it sort of reminded me a little of going to the grocery store this week. You see, I do go to the grocery store. I shop for my family and for my mother, who's elderly. And now, as we've been instructed, I wear a mask to the grocery store. And when I got there on Monday to do my shopping, it was very upsetting to me because I could not communicate the way I was used to. I couldn't smile at someone and say, oh, excuse me. Or I couldn't say, oh, good morning, and smile at them. They couldn't see half my face. It was like I was in a tomb. But Easter is nothing if not full of hope. And that is what it is, full of hope. And so I have hope that someday, on a day I don't know, and no one does, I don't think, that I will be able and we will all be able to take that mask off of our face and we can greet each other live and in person, not just through screens, but live and in person, and have no worries and be joyful in that. That's the hope that Easter brings us this year, I believe. I hope you have a wonderful Easter week.
Oh, Good morning, everyone, and welcome to this day of new light and new life, and a happy Easter to everyone. We're so glad that you are here with us today, and a big thank you to Bishop Ed for being with us here as our preacher today and bringing us his presence and his words of wisdom. And we'd also like to thank Bishop Coadjutor Elect Polson Reed for being with us on Holy Saturday as our preacher. And some things happening at the cathedral that are here for you. And a reminder that on Wednesdays and Saturdays, beginning at 10 a.m., we've got clergy-led devotions. And then on Sundays, beginning at 8 a.m., we have your Sunday service ready for you to tune in through either the email or through the website or through Facebook, either way. We have some new things that we are developing and invite you to take part. So glad that Sandra Opalka can be with us for Godly Play, and those are going to be offered Tuesdays at 10 a.m. And she started that earlier last week, and a wonderful, wonderful presentation. So we recommend that for you. And also on Facebook, a new Facebook group has started, and this is for St. Paul's Friends. And it's different from our other Facebook page in that it's a place to develop what we're calling holy friendships. And some wonderful things have been already posted on that, and we invite you all to take part. Simply go to St. Paul's Friends and join, and you'll be right there with us. A reminder also that if you are looking for staff or clergy and you need to send a message, go to our website, stpaulsokc.org, and you can find our emails there. And now may the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you this day and remain with you forever. Alleluia, alleluia. Let us go forth into the world rejoicing in the power of the Spirit. Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia. Mm-hmm.